Hello and welcome to Greatest Story Ever Told, video making by request, saying of circumstance. this is a fun song in terms of, it's actually a pretty easy song for the most part. Once you get it in your muscle memory, it's pretty straightforward from there. The fun part is that Phil takes just about every possible approach on the song. There's so many variations you can do. You basically, as long as you really know the song, you can kind of do anything. I mean, you obviously want to try and support the band and make sure that they are really solid. If they're at all shaky, you need to really simplify. But if they're solid, you can do a lot of fun stuff. Phil takes just about every approach you can think of on this. Basic song is in C. Intro is on C, just kind of repeated. Kind of a fade-in kind of thing, you know, which is not a very common thing for Phil to do, but it's brief, and, you know, you basically follow your Bobby. And then from there, it's just a quick C and C-F hits. And from there, you get to do a lot of variations, especially between the vocals. Bobby will sing a line. In between the lines, you can do a lot of stuff. That's the basic verse. You do that for a few times, and then you climb up to an A, E, C. Repeat that. One more time, and then you climb up to G, A, and D. Straightforward from there. Then you get to the hard part, which is sort of the, I don't even know what you call it on this song. It's sort of a bridge thing, or sort of the end of the verse. I guess you'd call it the end of the verse. It's sort of like that. And I got to admit, I don't really know how to count this. I just sort of play it mostly by muscle memory. And again, Phil takes pretty much every approach possible on this. I've heard him do it so many different ways. I do a real simple, just sort of straightforward just reading of the chords themselves, where it climbs up to an F and a G. And that whole bit repeats twice. And what I did there was a G, an F, G, C, B, B, A. That's a D. To G. Like I said, I know it by muscle memory. It's like my fingers know what to do, but my brain doesn't always do it as quickly as my fingers do. So that's basically what I do. You repeat that twice, and the second ending, you want to end on an E. So everybody else is playing a C chord, and you're playing an E. You know, which is obviously your major third, but it's pretty interesting to end a phrase on it. And I've heard Phil approach that E in different ways. I usually go, which is just A, G, F, E. But I've heard him do climb it up from C. Pretty much anything you could possibly imagine Phil has done. So let me run through it, and then we will have ourselves a video. Come on down and go. That's about it. I mean, with a flub or two in there, that's more or less the approach I take, and let me see how this comes out.